Hi, this is Rachel with Flow on Yoga, and today we're going to be doing a short chair yoga routine. And this week we've been talking about non-stealing, how we can not steal from ourselves or from others, and whether that's time or ego or comparison. And so I've been wanting to do a chair yoga practice for a lot of reasons, and I realized it would fit in this week because we can talk about how yoga doesn't have to look like maybe what we think in our head it has to look like. Yoga doesn't have to be a handstand or a back bend or a beautiful arm balance pose. Like, yoga can be something that you can do right here in your chair. And I know I have several people both in my family and following this channel that maybe this is what is accessible to them all the time, or maybe some of the time this is all that they can do. And you know, maybe even if you are doing those arm balances and those awesome back bends and all of those really awesome yoga poses, you can kind of live in a place of non-excess. I just said non-excess. You can live in a place of contentment and just kind of see what maybe doing yoga while sitting down in a chair has to offer for you. And I promise you, there is definitely some stuff that chair yoga has to offer. So let's get started. Find yourself a chair that's comfy. I actually was originally going to do this sitting on my front porch steps, but the camera was already set up here from me filming another workout earlier, so I just decided to just go with it and do it out here in the yard in a lawn chair. But front porch steps works. Inside in your comfy armchair, a recliner, whatever chair that you have, just grab a chair and let's get started. We're going to do primarily this whole workout, except right at the end, just totally optional. So find your comfortable seated position. I'm going to encourage you, if your chair, kind of like mine, kind of sits you back where you're kind of at an angle, you kind of sit up a little bit, and if maybe your back can't handle that, holding yourself up straight in this position, maybe getting a pillow and putting it behind your back, kind of finding a place where you can sit up tall and feel strong and supported if you need it by a pillow in the back. So once you get to whatever that comfortable seated position is for you, feet on the floor. Maybe your hands are here on your knees, maybe they're on the arms of your chair, if your chair has arms. Just kind of come to that place that's comfortable for you and start to bring your awareness to your breath. So deepen your inhales and your exhales through your nose. Inviting you to close your eyes, if you would like, if you're comfortable with that. Chest and your belly rising and falling, feeling all the space that you're creating, not just through the front of your body, but also through the side of your body, between your ribs and your back. Just feel how just breathing here deeply is giving your body a little bit of movement and a little bit of stretch just by taking. Ready. We're going to take our right ear towards our right shoulder on an exhale. Once you get to a place where you feel like that's where your neck wants to be, you feel your opposite shoulder, your left shoulder, kind of release and relax. We're not forcing it down, we're just trying to let go of that tension, just relax. And do the same thing with your right shoulder as well, just trying to relax your. And I want you to imagine on your inhale that you're growing taller. And on your exhale, that maybe you're moving a little deeper into that side stretch. Maybe you're not actually moving, but just notice how when you take that deep inhale, it does feel like your body's getting taller. And when you do that exhale, you can feel that stretch even more. And one more deep exhale. And on your next exhale, we're going to bring our chin around to our chest, and then just go ahead and work it all the way around until our left ear is going towards our left shoulder, letting your right shoulder release, relax. Again, not forcing it down, just letting it relax. And if you let go of the tension, you should feel your shoulder blades moving down your back, even though you're not forcing them. And letting go of your left shoulder too. And imagining on that inhale that your body is growing taller. And maybe noticing on that exhale how you can feel the stretch even deeper. By just taking deep breaths, that stretch even deeper, make us feel as if we are growing taller. And on your next exhale, we're going to bring our chin down around to our chest. And just take a moment to pause here. Relax, release, feeling that nice stretch up the back of your neck. And then slowly, very slowly, we're just going to start making small circles with our neck. Again, starting very small, and maybe if you want to, growing bigger, or maybe just staying small. Giving yourself permission to pause anywhere in these circles where your body might like a little bit more attention or stretch. Going as slowly as you want. We're moving a little quicker if you want. I mean, not Fresh Prince of Bel-Air kind of quickly, but we can speed them up a little bit if you want, if that's what feels good for you. Just whatever is calling to you today, making sure that those breaths are continuing steady and deep, inhales and exhales. Next time your right ear is over your right shoulder, we're going to pause and then reverse and take that circle in the opposite direction. Again, maybe starting small and growing bigger, or maybe just staying small the whole time. Stretch feels good. The next time your chin is down to your chest, we're going to pause. One deep inhale and one deep exhale. And a nice stretch to the back of your neck. And then on that next inhale, we're going to lift chin up, looking straight ahead, and maybe if you want, do a few shoulder rolls here, going up and forward and back, just like this, inhaling and exhaling as they go down, inhale, shoulders up, exhale, releasing. Next time your shoulders are up, switch it, exhale, shoulders go back, inhale, rounding forward and up. More of those. And the next time your shoulders are down, we're going to put our left arm either down by our sides or here, right here on the arm of your chair. And bring our right arm up by our ear. And we're just going to kind of tip to the side, making sure to keep your right hip rooted down into your seat. So we're not lifting like this. And I mean, you can experiment with that if you want. Do this and see how much of a stretch you feel down there. Because if you lift your hip, you're getting over really far, but you're really not doing much of a stretch. So keeping that right hip grounded and then tipping. And you really should feel that hip grounded and leaning over. You should really feel it all the way through your arm and down between each individual rib. Feel that nice stretch. Maybe looking up, maybe opening a little more, or maybe staying right here, or maybe even looking down with your neck, kind of finding what works for your neck. Exhale, we're going to mindfully lower our right hand. Inhale, left arm up, and we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Maybe opening our chest a little more and looking up, kind of bringing our shoulder blades a little closer together. Feeling that space we're creating all down the left side of our body. On an exhale, we're going to lower your left arm. Now on your next inhale, and again, it's going to depend whether you have arms on your chair or not. If you have arms on your chair, you come right here. If you don't, maybe coming down here to the side. And on a deep inhale, we're going to lift our arms. And then what I want you to do, and actually take these off, it's a little chilly out today. Take these off so it won't hold. We're going to kind of like walk up, just like a little micro bend to each side, kind of feeling like we're like walking ourselves taller. So if we're trying to create space between our ribs and like grow our torso up towards the sky or the ceiling if you're inside. So just like this. And see if you can feel, while trying to keep your shoulders relaxed, see if you can just feel space being created. Whenever you get to a place where you feel like you're nice and tall, maybe pausing right here and just holding that. Maybe looking up. On your next exhale, we're going to bring our hands together, our palms together. Exhaling down through heart center. I'm peeking over at my notes over here. I wrote this all out and I don't want to forget anything. So what we're going to do next is we're going to do little behind our back, stretching out our triceps. And you know, I meant to bring a towel out and I did, and I didn't. So I'm actually gonna take my jacket off so I can show you this, because I really want to show you a way that you can do this stretch even if you can't reach your arms behind your head. So if you have like a dish towel or a belt or a strap, t-shirt, a pillowcase, something, what we're going to do is a little tricep stretch. We're going to take our right arm and turn to the side so you can see this here. And if you can reach your left arm back here and grab, that's great. If you cannot, but you still want to get that same stretch through your tricep, what we can do is we can use this, and you grab one end in one hand and one in the other, and then just with your bottom arm, give it a little tug, and you're going to get, whichever way you're doing this, you're going to get the exact same stretch in your tricep, whether or not your hand can make it there or not. And the important thing we're doing here is not, our hands meeting is not what's important. It's getting that stretch through your tricep. So using that cloth or that belt or that strap or that pullover in my case is great. That's a way to make this stretch accessible to you. On your next exhale, we're going to very slowly, we're going to release with our right hand first, bringing our left hand around. Maybe we need to shake our arms out a little bit, roll your shoulders, and we're going to do that same thing on the other side. Again, using this again if you need it. If you don't, feel free to just bring your hands together. So we're going to do left elbow up, trying to keep it close to our ear, right hand back, and then a nice little tug, again using that strap, towel, pillowcase. You should feel a nice stretch right down through here. If you're not feeling that, maybe try giving a little more of a tug with your bottom arm. Or maybe try lifting your elbow up towards the sky a little bit more. One more deep breath here and we're going to let it go. We're going to let go the top arm first. And then the bottom arm. I'm gonna move this over here to the side. Now we're gonna move it down. We've done our neck and our shoulders and some with our arms, a little bit here. So now we're gonna pay a little bit of attention to our hips. We're gonna start out just doing some little hip circles. So just doing some small, I'm going towards the right and counterclockwise. And then maybe growing those circles a little bit, maybe kind of opening, making this into kind of a seated cat-cow with a little bit of a circle. So maybe opening as you come through the front and exhaling and arching your back as you come around to the back. That is totally optional though. And feel free just to keep moving through those circles. If you are doing that like seated cat-cow motion, try to do an inhale as you open and squeeze your shoulder blades together, and then an exhale as you round and tuck your chin into your chest. Again, through all of this, we're trying to keep our breath steady, flowing and deep. We're trying to keep our back straight. So maybe check in, and if you start out feeling strong and straight, but you find out now maybe you're like hunching back, maybe grab a pillow and give some support to your back, trying to keep your back straight. Next time you're forward, pause and then take it in the other direction. Again, maybe starting small, and then maybe growing into that cat-cow. Seated motion, exhaling back, inhaling forward. Maybe lifting your gaze, maybe really feeling your shoulder blades pulling apart as you come around back into the cat, maybe even kind of using your knees to kind of tug on a little bit. Next time you're forward, we're gonna pause and using your knees or maybe the arms of your chair, we're gonna come back to neutral spine. Again, just like I said before, check in. See if your posture is still feeling good. See if maybe you need to add some support to your back. And what we're gonna do next is on an inhale, we're gonna lift our arms up. Maybe creating a little bit of space between your legs. And we're gonna try to do a forward fold. So make a little bit of space here. Maybe moving your feet about shoulder distance apart. So hip distance is about here. Shoulder distance, just a little bit wider. So on an inhale, we're gonna lift up. Exhale, either bring your arms out wide or down through heart center. We're gonna fold, keeping your back flat. Folding down. And just taking a moment here in this forward folded position to kind of release and let go. And if you find that you're having trouble reaching the ground here, you can use your legs. You can maybe put some books or some blocks or some pillows or something here to lift you up a little bit. That's great. If putting your head down is something that's not accessible for you, you can always just do a flat back like this. Keep our head above our heart. Or we can bring our arms to the ground and release our head and neck into this forward fold pose. Next inhale, we're going to press into the floor, your legs, a block, whatever you're using, and try to flatten and stretch our backs out. Maybe this is where you already were. Take a deep inhale and exhale, kind of feeling the crown of your head extending out in front of you. And we're going to take our right hand right in between our feet. Again, maybe if you're up here, maybe you have a block, books or a pillow, or maybe you need to use your chair right here between your legs for that. And wave to my kids who are watching me through the door. So wherever your hand is, just find a place that you can plant your right hand down. And on an inhale, we're going to take this left arm up and open. Remembering to keep those breaths steady and deep and flowing, even when we're twisted, which sometimes makes us want to interfere with our breathing, start breathing a little shallower, or maybe even holding our breath, but just keep that breath moving. Again, maybe your stretch is up here. That's fine too. You should still feel this lovely opening all through your chest and shoulder, even if you're right here. Next exhale, we're going to bring your left arm back down. This time we're going to plant the left hand either right here between your feet or maybe up here or on a block or a stack of books or a pillow or whatever you are using. Really press firmly in, and then we're going to lift and open. things I really love about yoga is it is something that can be for anyone. Yoga, and I a lot of times what you see in the media, on magazines, on Facebook, on Instagram, are people doing these poses that, I mean, they look like you need to be a gymnast to be able to do them, but that is part of what yoga is, but that is not all of what yoga is, and it has so many great things to offer. And I feel like a lot of people may feel intimidated by seeing someone doing a handstand and think, well, I can't do that, so yoga's not for me. Exhale, we're going to come back down into that flat back. So I think knowing that yoga is something you can do in a chair, it's something you can do with never getting up off the floor. You can do yoga while seated the entire time. You can do yoga sitting in your car taking some deep mindful breaths. Like, there is something for everybody in yoga, and yoga is not just for people that used to be gymnasts or can do back bends and arm balances. You can do yoga in a chair. On an exhale, we're gonna release back into that forward fold. Inhale, we're going to very mindfully, just slowly from wherever you are, walk it back up into a seated position. We're going to do, let me check and make sure I'm not missing anything. Okay, we are very close then. We're going to do one more stretch with our legs, and then we're going to do a very, very short cool down, and then I'm going to show you a really cool resting pose that I like, and feel free to try it out if that's accessible to you, or just ignore it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to extend our right leg, and maybe, if you can, maybe try coming to the edge of your chair, and you can extend your leg even more. Or if you stay back here, that's fine too. We can do this from here, or we can come to the edge of our chair. Extend our right leg. On an inhale, we're going to come up and sit. Try to bring your belly button where it's kind of towards this leg. So you're trying to kind of center your torso towards this leg. Inhale up and exhale. We're just going to lean forward, hinge forward. I need to scoot forward a little more. There's a bar in this chair that's keeping me from going too far. It hurts. So hinging forward. Maybe needing to drop your arm for some support. Maybe having some blocks here. Maybe using your chair. Maybe using the arms or the side of your chair as some support. Whichever version of this works for you. This is kind of like a variation of either like seated with one leg on the ground, or even almost kind of like doing a pyramid pose when we're standing, where we have our forward leg straight and we're bowing over it. So wherever you are, I want you to try to let your head and neck just relax. Just try to soften. Again, if that's here, or maybe with some blocks here, just try to find a little stillness and ease in this pose. Keeping that breath moving. And one more inhale. And one more exhale. And I'm going to very slowly walk it out of that. Bring your right leg back in. And if you're up kind of more on the edge of your chair like I am, stay right there. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to extend your left leg. And then again, whatever you did on the other side, feel free to do that again. Or maybe are going to realize that something you did on the other side doesn't feel right on this side, or maybe something that you wanted to try on this side but wasn't accessible, maybe it is on this side. Like I've said before, our bodies are not symmetrical, so feel free to play around. You do not have to do the same thing on this side that you did on the other. So on an inhale, wherever you are right now, we're going to lift, and then exhale, hinge from the hips, and fold. And again, trying to get to that place where you feel supported and strong, and then try to find some release in your head and your neck, and then try to find some
keeping that breath flowing. Inhale and exhale. And on your next inhale, very slowly and mindfully, not pressing down on your knee,
walk out of this position and re-bend that left leg, staying right where you are. We're going to try, and maybe you need to sit back in your chair for this, kind of play with it, see how it feels. We're going to try hugging our knees up into our chests, and I'm probably going to have to scoot back because this chair is kind of angled this way. And it's making me feel like I want to tilt back when I try to take the weight out of my legs. So we're going to try to lift our legs up, grab them, hug them in, bring our chest forward towards our knees. Oh, there we go. Now it's tipping me forward. Just kind of holding up here. Maybe bowing our head down if we want. This should feel really nice after that stretch we just did in our legs, hugging everything in. Maybe finding a little movement. You feel more steady in your chair than I do in this one, on the ground, on a pillow. Maybe letting your shoulder blades release and relax a little bit. Maybe tucking your chin towards your chest. Maybe your forehead towards your knees. Or maybe not. Maybe for you, if this isn't feeling good, maybe yours today is hugging your knees down here. Like that. That works too. So wherever you are, take one more. This pillow is just rocking and rolling me all around. Take one more deep inhale. We're going to sigh out through our mouth. One more. Deep inhale and loud audible sigh. Slowly release. To move anything that needs to be moved. Now, if you want, for your final resting pose, you can stay right here in your chair. Maybe you can lean back now. Maybe remove that pillow. Maybe if you're in a recliner, just recline on back. Maybe going forward a little bit, finding whatever's comfortable for you. If you want to try something a little different than staying in our chair or from even a normal laying down shavasana, I'm going to offer for you the option of, hopefully you can stick your hand around this way, of laying in shavasana with our feet up. So we're going to still use this chair. We're going to get our bottoms pretty close to the chair and then put our feet up in the chair like this, trying to get like the edge of the chair right in behind your knees where it's touching. And then relaxing down. This is kind of a variation of legs up the wall. So you can also do this at a wall. So if you have a wall, you can do the same thing and just have your legs up against the wall like this. That also feels amazing. So whichever shavasana you're gonna do, go ahead and get settled in. Inviting you to close your eyes and start releasing and letting go of anywhere you're feeling tension in your body. And I invite you, if you have the time now, to pause this video and take 10 minutes here if you can to, or more. More is great too, to lay in this resting pose, whichever version that you've chosen today.